Hope you're having an amazing day. Today we're taking a look at this air CPU cooler here. This is the Dark Rock Elite. This is from Be Quiet. I did a review recently of the Dark Rock Pro 5, and it has some pretty similar features to this one. So if you want to go ahead and check out that video, today we're going to go ahead and kind of take a look at the whole air cooler here, and then we're going to go ahead and mount it and do some stress test on it, and you can kind of see the thermals and everything like that. So let's go ahead and open up the box here and see what we have inside. So first we get this smaller box here, which pretty much contains all your AMD Intel setups, and here we also have the manual. Alrighty, so we got the main cooler here, so let's go ahead and take a look. So the front, we got a 135 millimeter fan, so the same thing in the middle as well. And to go ahead and remove the middle fan, all you need to do is remove the top cover here, which is magnetic, as you can see here, four of them. And then we can remove the middle fan here. So this is a 2000 RPM fan and 135 millimeter. So looking at the middle fan here, we got a few cables. I'll show you in a second what those do. So here at the top, we do have the Q and P. So that's if you want to set the fans on quiet and performance here. And also we do get some lighting here, some ARGB as well. And we can see a few cables here. So one of them is for the RGB. And then we have the main fan cable. And here we have the input for the front fan. So that way you can control both fans via the switch here from the quiet to performance. When you're switching at performance, the fan can go up to 2000 RPM, and in quiet mode, it can go up to 1500 RPM. So the whole piece here is aluminum, and it does have seven heat pipes here, which should keep things pretty cool. So we do get the included thermal paste. So we're gonna go ahead and install everything, run some stress test, and we're gonna check out the thermals as well, and also listen to how loud these fans get as well. So I've gone ahead and installed the bracket, so everything fits perfectly fine here. And now pretty much, we're just gonna need to put the paste, and also don't forget to remove the sticker here. Just before you go ahead and install the air cooler here, just make sure you're putting it in the direction you want to put it in the first place, because after you're not going to be able to really grab this front fan and put it in the back here, because this one is kind of like screwed in there, so you're not able like to really take this out and put it on this other side here. So as we can see, like the audio levels were hovering around 41. Our room temperatures is like around 22, 23 right now. And let's go ahead and turn on the system now. And then you're also gonna see the thermals and everything else here. And here right away, we can see some nice RGB colors. So that definitely looks very nice, as you can see here. So on performance, as you can see, it's going around 50 dBs here. And it's a little bit loud, I would say. But when everything is like enclosed in a case, you're not gonna be hearing as much as I'm hearing now. So if I go ahead and put it to quiet mode, let's see how much it drops. So around 44. So definitely, I don't think that's gonna be any issue at all. Even on performance or quiet mode, it's not gonna, once you this is all enclosed, you're not gonna be hearing it that much. So take a look at the current system temperature. We're hovering around 27 Celsius, and it's going like 15, 17 watts here. So let's go ahead and run the benchmark now. So the CPU we're using right now, it's the 11900K, and turbo mode and everything is on, XMP is on. All right, so the test is finished. I'm just gonna go ahead and actually turn to quiet mode here. And looks like we got some, definitely some better results here. Comparing this to the Dark Rock 5 Pro, where we hovered around 81 Celsius here, we only went up to 73 Celsius. And if we're looking at the score, we got a higher score. And the wattage and everything looks good too. So definitely it's doing a much, much better job. And it looks better. In my point of view, it definitely does look nicer here, the way it's built. And plus you're getting the RGB here if you're a fan of that. So that's definitely a bonus there. And better fans as well. You're getting two better fans, 2000 RPM, comparing to the like 1700. And it's moving, definitely moving some good air here. Like I can definitely feel it. So one thing we know is we're definitely able to go ahead and remove the middle fan here if you wanna go ahead and clean the whole thing. Also, you're able to remove the front fan as well. So it just like slides up and then you're able like to take it off. So that is an option there. If you have any questions about this certain cooler here, go ahead and leave a comment below. I really hope you enjoyed this video. Also, don't forget to subscribe if you're new here. I'll see you on the next one.